We all know how crucial it is to have a website for your business. But what if I told you that you could create a fully functional website all for free? I'm Thomas, and this is How to HubSpot. We'll be using HubSpot's free website builder. To follow along, click on the link in the description down below, and let's get started. We're going to go on to the left-hand side column and click on Content and then Web Pages. On the top right, you're going to go down to Create. Let's name this page Home. Here we have a whole bunch of options for templates. This is all under the theme of Designly. You can check out more themes that you have by clicking on Change Theme. So these are all the themes that I've downloaded previously. However, we have way more options available to us if we click on the Marketplace. Let's go check those out. So in HubSpot's Template Marketplace, there are tons of options that we can choose from. You can either filter out by business types, page features, and so much more. We're gonna go ahead and choose one of the free ones. I've already done that, but to show you how it's done, let's say we wanna use Thrifty. You'll click on Preview, then you'll click on View Details, and then click Install. This will then install the theme into your library, and you can start from there. Let's go back to my theme library, and we're gonna go ahead and choose Designly. So like I said, we're building a homepage, so I'm gonna select the home template. It's incredibly easy to start customizing your webpage. You can simply start clicking on modules and start to edit whatever you'd like. But let's take a moment to step back and understand the structure of the page. Pages are made up of sections. Within each section is a column. And then within the column, they hold modules. Modules can come in a form of text, images, forms, and more. Let's go ahead and add a custom header. So we can get rid of this. All right, we've added our custom header. Let's just change the color over here so that looks a little better. And then we'll delete the body paragraph below that and delete this button over here. We also don't want this image, so I'm gonna delete that as well. Okay, now we wanna change the background because this doesn't quite look the way I'd like it to look. I'm gonna click on background and I'm gonna add an image that I previously uploaded. This is looking beautiful. Now let's edit the modules on the next section. You can use HubSpot's AI called Breeze to help you customize any of the content seamlessly. If you wanna learn more about Breeze, feel free to check out our playlist on our channel. So let's use AI to change this header. All you have to do is select the header, refine, and choose something else. Copilot will pop up on the right-hand side, and then you just have to send in a prompt for the new header. Once you have your prompt, click send. Copilot will then work to generate a new header for you, and if you like what you see, just hit replace. Now that new header is instantly added to your webpage. Let's do the same thing with the body paragraph below. I'm gonna highlight this. Refine into something else. Once I've added my prompt, I'll hit send, and Copilot's gonna generate a body paragraph, and I'm gonna insert that onto the page. Something that's also really neat that I enjoy, you can highlight any paragraph, click refine, and expand what's already written, or in the other case, you can shorten those as well. Okay, this is looking really nice right now. I'm gonna delete this bottom little list because I don't need that. And now we wanna generate a new image. So all you have to do is click on the image, replace image, and then on the bottom, choose Generate with AI. Now you'll insert your image prompt, which I'm gonna go ahead and do. And I like the dimension of square, so I'm gonna keep that, and now we can generate our image. It generated two images for us, and between these two, I like the one on the right. I'm gonna click on that, and I'm gonna hit Insert. And then apply changes on the left-hand side. And just like that, we've produced a clean image with clean copy in a matter of minutes. Right now, I really like how this looks, and I wanna add a little bit more depth to it. So let's go to the top left here, and click Add. And as I've mentioned earlier, we have three components, modules, sections, and layouts that make up the page. Under modules, you have theme-specific ones, which are specific to the theme that you've chosen for your webpage, text, commerce, design, functionalities, forms and buttons, and a whole lot more. Then we have sections, where you can choose different sections and drag and drop them wherever you'd like on your page, and then layouts. Let's go back to sections because I wanna add a testimonial section to this homepage. I'm gonna take this and I'm gonna drag it just below our copy here. And now I'm gonna start editing the testimonial section. Adding these sections really adds personality to your webpage, which is exactly what you want to get people to see when they come to your site. The first thing we wanna do is replace the quote. And then we wanna replace the image with an icon and also change the person who provided this quote for us. I wanna add two more testimonials to this column. So I'm gonna hit clone twice, once and then twice. Okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and edit both of these testimonials. Okay, now that we've added all of our testimonials, we're just gonna delete the rest of the sections that we don't need. Go ahead and delete this section that one, and this last one. Okay, I really like where we are at with our homepage. Before we add more pages to our website, we just need to add a title and meta description for the homepage. In order to do that, we're gonna go up to settings and add in our page title here, which we will call home. Then next, you wanna add your content slug, which I will have as home next to my domain. And then for your meta description, you can actually have AI generate a meta description for you. But for this example, I'm just gonna put it in my own description. Okay, and then you wanna add a featured image to be shared on social media, which I'm gonna turn on, and I'm going to select an image that I've already created. All right, we're ready to go and add more pages to our website. To do that, I'm gonna exit out of this, in the top left-hand corner, back to our dashboard. In the top right, add website page. Now I'm gonna add a products page. Page name, products, create page. I'm gonna select portfolio for this. And just like we did for the homepage, you can customize this product page by adding in sections, modules, and columns. Awesome, so by using some of the AI tools and drag and drop features, I've created my products page. Let's go ahead and add two more pages to this website so we can have four total, and then we'll connect all of those pages together. We go back to our website dashboard, and like I said, I'm gonna add two more pages. So I just added an about page and a contact page. We have four pages overall. Remember to use Breeze's Copilot to help you customize your content for your pages. And make sure that each page is optimized. So in order to check that your page is optimized, you can go in the left-hand bar here, click optimize, and it'll tell you all the recommendations that you can take to optimize your page. Now, before we connect all of our pages together in a menu, we wanna change the main header logo and footer logo on the bottom. So let's go ahead and change the header. If you click on your header and click on Open in Global Content Editor, this is where you'll change your logo. Click on the logo, logo on the left-hand side, click Override Default Logo. Here, I'm gonna choose the logo that I would like to replace it with, and then I'm going to change the width because I don't like how that looks. 500 should be good. Beautiful, that's looking very nice. So in the top right-hand corner, we'll publish. Whenever you edit anything in the global content editor, you have to remember that that logo and those menus will show across all your assets and all your pages. So it's critical to understand that any changes you make here will reflect on other pages. Now let's change the footer. Click on global content here, go into the editor, and we wanna change this logo to the same logo we have for the header. Upload images. We're gonna go ahead and upload our logo. And this is also a little big. Let's change that to 500. Beautiful. And as you can tell, the colors here don't match our brand colors either. So we can go in there and change that too. Go to styles here and go to fill. And we're gonna choose our brand color. Love this. We're gonna go ahead and publish it on the top right-hand corner. We are very close to completing our website. The last thing we need to do is create a menu and the header and connect all our pages so we can publish. Again, we're gonna go back into the global content editor, and on the left-hand side panel, we're gonna go down to menu and create new. Let's call this menu Paw Plates Menu. Create, and then add menu item. The first menu item label is going to be called home, and we are gonna link the homepage. Then we're gonna add another item with page link and link the products page. Then we're gonna add the about page. And lastly, we're gonna add the contact page. Once you've added all your pages that you wanna connect, on the right-hand side, click save. Once you've added all the items to your menu and you don't see them on the top right-hand corner here, that's because your pages probably weren't published. So make sure to publish all your pages. To publish your page, you're gonna go to the website dashboard. As you can see here, our products page has not been published. So all I have to do is click the box here, publishing options, publish, and hit publish. All our menu items are shown, and just make sure in the top right-hand corner that you publish your global content that you've just added. And there you have it. I just created a beautiful business website from beginning to end, full with customized content, all for free. If you wanna get your business started today, build a free website using our free website builder in the description down below. I hope this video was helpful. Please leave a comment down below for anything else that you'd like to learn. I'm Thomas, and this is How to HubSpot. See you next time.